Node.js. So here's the PRS slide. I'm in the lab since February last year. I have one publication on my PhD topic, which I will be presenting today. So when we look at our society and the people that are above the age of 85, we can see that this highly correlates with the number of hearing disease patients. So keeping that in mind, a good noise reduction and a good hearing aid keeps those patients or enhances their daily life, actually. So when we talk about hearing aids and noise reduction, we need to know a few constraints that we need to consider. So one is online processing. So we can't use the whole signal as input for our algorithm. We can't just wait 1 or maybe 10 seconds that we have the full sequence to output a denoised or a speech enhanced version. And furthermore, we have a very limited frequency resolution where multiple frequency or multiple speech harmonics could be in one frequency band, and I will have an example very soon. And obviously the power consumption and computational power is not that huge from hearing aids, but this is not yet considered in this work. So the hearing aid pipeline that I'm working with is showed on this picture, and we can see in the beginning we have some kind of audio signal that is recorded with some microphones. We transform it into frequency domain using an analysis filter bank, and this is very similar to a short time Fourier transformation. Then we do some directional processing, which results then in a single channel signal. And this is used for our noise reduction. And in the end, the signal is transformed back to time domain, so we can listen to it using a synthesis filter bank. What is the actual input of our noise reduction algorithm? Here we can see a high-resolution spectrogram of a speech signal. And we can see the typical speech harmonics from the voice parts of the speech. But unfortunately, our input looks like this, where we don't see the speech harmonics because our frequency resolution is very little. Multiple speech harmonics can be within one frequency band. So how can we work with this? To reduce the noise also within the different speech harmonics. And to do that, I want to first introduce you to linear predictive coding. So linear predictive coding provides a method to model harmonic and periodic signals. And here we see some synthesized signal. And linear predictive coding then tries to predict the next frame of the signal given a linear combination of the order n of the previous frames and a coefficient A. So this is just a linear combination, and we can compute ideal coefficients A by minimizing the error between the predicted signal and the real signal and solving an equation system, so we get a closed form solution for computing the coefficients A. And then we can model the signal quite good given only the last n frames. And you might see it, the yellow signal is the reconstructed signal, and the blue signal is the original signal, and there are some parts that are not reconstructed, but a fully periodic signal can be almost perfectly be reconstructed. And when we look at the frequency response of the reconstruction, we can see that LPC models only the most relevant frequencies. So for instance, if we have some white noise in there, white noise has the same magnitude for all frequencies, so LPC should not model those or this white noise. How can this help us with our approach? So the spectrogram that has a very low resolution also has some periodic structures. So here we can see the complex, or we can see a log power spectrogram. And we can see the periodic structure in here. And when we look at just one frequency band, one spectral component, we can see that the real and imaginary parts are also periodic. And also the frequency spectrum of just this second spectral component shows that there are some clear spikes in there. And LPC should be able to model those spikes. So we want to use linear predictive coding, basically as the formula above, but for each frequency bin F. So basically do linear predictive coding in each band. So how can we do this? Well, we can use a neural network to predict those LPC coefficients at inference time. And the goal is to get a denoised speech-enhanced spectrogram as output. Here we want to, we can train the network using the ideal coefficients that we can compute on training time, given the clean spectrogram. However, the result is still not optimal and only slightly reduced noise, because the ideal LPC coefficients are only valid for parts where we have voiced speech. For instance, here we have voice speech, or in the beginning we have voice speech, and for all parts where we have unvoiced speech or no speech at all, those coefficients are not very meaningful. So they are not zero, they just can be anything. And those coefficients are not helpful to denoise the signal. Therefore, well, what we can use is the clean speech time domain signal. So we just use the clean speech signal and implicitly force the network to denoise the spectrogram using the linear combination of the of LPC, but we allow the network to model and implicitly allow as setting the coefficients to zero, so it can actually denoise the signal. So we know that LPC works well. However, not for all parts of the signal. So the linear combination is actually a good thing for all parts where we have voiced speech, and for all parts where we don't have any speech, then we just need to allow the network to zero every coefficient, so it can actually denoise also those parts. To formulate it, it's just the linear combination, and in contrast to linear predictive coding, I propose complex linear coding, because we work in the complex domain and we don't have to predict the next frame anymore. We can just use the linear combination and add an additional offset parameter L, which also allows to incorporate information of the current time step and even future time steps, since also future context helps to predict better coefficients. So let's look at some results. Here is a noisy speech sample. Maybe we can listen to it. Or not. Okay, so this is a quite noisy sample. And there's some German speech in there, but it's not clearly, we cannot listen to it very good. So, and the resulting denoised output looks like this, and here CLC is able to also reduce the noise for parts where we don't have any voice speech and where we don't have any speech. And actually CLC is also able to reduce the noise within frequency bands. So note that this is a high resolution spectrogram of the resulting audio, and the linear combination didn't have such a good frequency resolution. So here CLC is also able to reduce the noise between those frequency bands. And I will show first an example with previous work before we listen to it. So here on the left-hand side, we can see some conventional real-valued processing, and we can see that here there's still noise left, and traditional processing can only reduce everything or keep it like this. So either speech gets degraded or the noise is we are left in there. And using CLC, we can reduce also noise between frequency bands. Now let's listen to it. First, the conventional Wiener gain method. So you can hear that the noise is reduced. However, you can hear also that there's some artifacts in there, and this is mostly due to the noise that is still left in during between the speech harmonics. So this means the magnitude, the resulting magnitude, is quite good that the Wiener gain method, predicted. However, the phase is very distorted. And now let's listen to the CLC output. All right, or maybe not. Okay, now you can hear that there are the distortions are not so strong anymore. And we can also see this looking at some metrics, and here we can see that especially for very noisy conditions with an SNR of -5 or 0, that CLC outperforms previous work by a huge amount, and for conditions that are not so noisy, Wiener gain method works also quite good. So this concludes my talk. Thank you very much.